So as we look further down this church mosaic, we can see the Christ figure, the light, figure of light, amidst the 12 houses of the zodiac, each in their group of three. There are four groups of three there. Further down here, we see the Christogram positioned up above the cross here, within the Vesica Pisces, the IHC, or the IHS, perhaps pronounced yes, as in yes, Yeshua, Jesus, the yes, that affirmative word we use all the time, the yes, the son, the hero. And that is perhaps the hero behind the cross there within the church. We have another cross here. The Vesica Pisces is positioned in the centre of this cross. The downward aspect, the vertical aspect being the male, with the lateral part here being the female aspect of the cross. IHC in the centre there, the Christogram. An interesting configuration on the cross. Above here we have inverted pentagrams. The arms of the pentagram perhaps represent earth, water, air and fire, and with the spirit and ether being the fifth arm, which is perhaps the one pointing down in this case, which is something that a dark occultist might do as a within their symbology. What the church here in this case, or how they decipher the symbol, I'm not exactly sure. So we now positioned up the front of the church, and there is a bath here. So this is for the baptism of members of the church. They immerse themselves in the water, particularly the head of the individual. So this is perhaps an act where you have earth, as far as the ascension of spirit goes. Let's say you have the you have earth, then water, then air, then fire. So this is a step up from earth, let's say, with this baptism. Of course, Christians take the Bible literally, so they have their own sort of literal meanings for these things. Well, these are literal Christians, I should say. So I've included this imagery here. As I've shown before in prior videos, many of the airlines around the world have the red fire triangle amidst their logo. Qantas has it here, it's quite obvious, and this is the old Ansett logo with two fire triangles in it, and the Aviation Development Australia Limited logo with the two fire triangles. Once again, referring to the ascension path of spirit. So we have earth, water, air and fire. So I ponder that it is that the fire triangle is positioned on planes, aeroplanes, in part because the aeroplane flies above the air, let's say, symbolically. So there you have the red fire triangle above the air. Now, this is a book, The Phoenix by Manly P. Hall, and we'll just have a look at an illustration inside of that. The spiral of life here, and here we can see terra firma, aqua, the water, A-E-R, air, and ignis, the flame or fire. We have the moon above that. But so that's that progression that I was talking about there. This is called the spiral of life, this particular drawing. And here is a reference for that, for those who are interested in looking at it. This is a further illustration where perhaps in the centre here we have the earth with the water, and then perhaps the clouds here, and then the fire, and then we have the moon, the lunar moon, and then so forth through to Saturnus and all the rest of it. So we're back within the church here, and we have Aries, the ram, or the lamb here, the Lamb of Christ. In the Northern Hemisphere, that is the first constellation in the zodiac for when the sun rises above the Earth's equatorial plane. We have the Vesica Pisces here. So this is a new sort of modern style of window here in the church. We have the lion, Leo, depicted here, and the eagle or phoenix, which is actually a representation of Scorpio, because this sort of eagle resides in Scorpio. Down the bottom here we have, we'll just go down to that, there we have the sun on the cross, we have the bull, Taurus, and across here we have a figure who's actually writing, but this is where Aquarius is, the position of Aquarius. This is in Bondi. This is the sports girl's shop, and I've included a the symbol for the Order of the Eastern Star here. And as you can see, the colours align with the colours on here. So this is girl. Now the Order of the East, the Order of the Eastern Star, is something that women participate in. So here we have a similarity. And here is that shop, that franchise in Bourke Street, Melbourne also. And within it here in the shop front, we have this globe with the United Nations of Style on it. We also have this design here from and within that you can get the flower of life and so forth. So it's interesting what they sort of put in the shops here. And on the wall here we have the rainbow as well, these rainbow colours. Now this is alluding perhaps to another part of this, and that is that we have the International Order of the International Order of the Rainbow for Girls, which is also connected to Freemasonry. And on the ground here, we have this compass configuration with this part here pointing to the east or northeast. Now, the east side is actually pertains to the right, so the right side of the brain. So this perhaps pertains to enlightenment. Here we can see some blocks with a rough side and a smooth side, which perhaps pertains to the Freemasons with their rough ashlar and smooth ashlar. Here in Sydney, you can see the rough side to what is perhaps a keystone. You have the smooth sides around here with the rough side here. In Freemasonry, the rough ashlar perhaps pertains to a person who is a so-called rough diamond. And then, of course, the smooth to a more refined person, a person who has perhaps gone from a lower state to a higher state of consciousness, let's say. So we'll just keep going through here. We have these skeletons on the blocks also, which perhaps relate to death, the notion of death and time. And these perhaps in turn relate to Father Time, to Saturnalia. We have a statue here of the Chief of Justice of Victoria. Now, this perhaps all relates to a Saturnalian aspect to the system of law that we live under, the ecclesiastical Roman system that perhaps goes further back to Babylon. And we currently live under a morphization, if you will, of that law in its now current state. Here we have Father Time, who is in the Royal Arcade in Melbourne with his little timer there. I just put this in as a bit of a reference to what is perhaps a Saturnalian aspect to the configuration of blocks here. Let's keep moving on. Oh, by the way, the Chief of Justice here has currently got a sticker on his forehead saying Occupy, where the third eye is. So that would perhaps be a remnant from the Occupy protests that were happening here in Melbourne. And that's the old Treasury building. We're just going up. This is an interesting design here. We have what is perhaps the dot within a circle, the dot perhaps pertaining to God, to a godlike figure in the outer, perhaps pertaining to the greater creation. And we also have the Vesica Pisces included in this design, so it's got a couple of things incorporated into the design there, and perhaps more. Beautiful old building. We're just looking up here. This is the New South Wales Parliament building up there. So this is another look at the old Treasury building, though. And up here we have the Holy Grail sitting in here. Enlightenment, the Holy Grail. Beautiful old building. The old Treasury building. Up the sides of the door here we have these discs, once again, which perhaps relate to the dot within a circle. And we'll get a close-up look at those. There they are, they line the door, a dot within a circle. And here we can see that dot within a circle again. Now these are in the Carlton Gardens here in Melbourne, laid out in the garden. So we'll just take a bit of a look above Melbourne here. That's that dot within a circle configuration just there in Carlton Gardens. I believe this is a university ground here. What we possibly have, it's an oval here, but it's possibly represents more of a circle, the making it a sun window with the outer part here, perhaps going down to here, but and then you'd have the rays coming out here, so there is perhaps a sun window type design within the layout here. Here we have a circle with these paths coming out, which also perhaps alludes to the sun. But, you know, we're just looking at possibilities here. This is the Children's Hospital. Here is a closer shot of that Children's Hospital from above. And here still closer. And we possibly have two squares in here. Whether or not this is a design designed by Masons or other, you know, has an occult aspect to it, I'm not sure, but it's certainly an interesting design to look at all the same. This is the, these are the Fitzroy Gardens in East Melbourne, very close to the main city here. In fact, the Treasury building's just about here, actually. So within this garden, we have this part here, which is perhaps an arm of the compass. But there isn't one here that sort of starts off from there, but then you don't really have that arm. But you do have the square here as well. I couldn't trace as to whether the designer of the garden was a Freemason or not, but it's a curious design. And we also have what is perhaps the Union Jack within this design as well. But they don't necessarily have to be a Freemason, but there are still interesting aspects to this garden design.